Doris Legge and Vi Churchill have been San Remo residents and neighbours for more than 50 years.
We were the backbone of the town, really, because there were no men. You sort of had to help each other.
The story about the women of San Remo is unique. Tubby Cleland talks about the challenges of being a fishing village.
Fishing industry, fishing port, they are a little bit more closer-knit. You know, it's a tough old gig being from a fishing family, you know.
Tubby reflects on her childhood in San Remo and the challenges her mother faced.
She did it hard because the boat was away, you know. My dad was a crayfisherman and they used to go away 3 weeks at a time. Sometimes they'd get stuck over the other side, couldn't get home for a month, 6 weeks. Then there'd be many times when they couldn't go to sea, so no income. But, you know, she came from a farming town, lived and worked off the farm, came here and she had the backbone to get out there and do a bit. And there's been some, you know, very sad disasters come out of this little town. The women had to have rise to the occasion. Times when, you know, the men weren't at home. And so most of the women really were both mother and father to a lot of the kids in the town.
Heather Mobilia grew up on a dairy farm just out of San Remo. She remembers the tension that used to exist around the town when the fishermen were at sea.
The time when the weather was pretty bad, the boats would have to go and shelter wherever they were at King Island or down in those Tasmanian islands. And the concern that would be around, you felt, I remember that sort of concern that was around. And also, over the years, there were at different times loss of life with some tragedies, and the whole town felt it. And the women in particular, that fear was at the back of their mind, because when it does happen, it could be happened to them.
In times of adversity and times of tragedy, the women banded together and got things done. Vi Churchill talks about the lengths that the San Remo women would go to help each other out.
And my 16-year-old brother was killed down at Noble Park on the road, and I had a new baby. I called Doris and I told her that David had been killed, and I said, I have to go to Port Fairy. She said, don't worry, just bring the baby over to me. And she said, you don't need the worry of the baby, you're going to have to be with your parents. And so Doris just took over the baby and the kids and off we went. I got held there longer than what I thought it would have been, but Doris mothered them all and cared for them.
You got them back just as good as they came to me, didn't you?
Yeah, better probably.
For Doris Legge, having a car and having a licence presented a whole new set of challenges.
We had a car and my son played footy, so we had half San Remo crammed into the car. You couldn't do it today. They were nursing each other. We'd go from here to Glen Elvie or wherever. Everybody did it. You know, it was just what happened. I was able to drive, which was very fortunate. Viola didn't drive. I tried to teach her.
So did my husband. I tried and I grated the gears and I got into trouble. So just said, well, you can stick your car, and I got out.
Behind the scenes, women kept San Remo running. Heather Mobilia thinks about the businesses in Main Street.
Well, there were a lot of small business owners, and I think in those days too, the women were working alongside the man. And so I go up the main street and you had the Bowens and Mrs. Cochran, and later on in the Western Port Hotel, Betty Ross, very much involved. Elaine Williams at the San Remo Hotel and the Williams Hotel, very much working in the hotel daily and involved and whatever else. Lyle, of course, would be the front man and everyone, Lyle's pub, Lyle's this, and, you know, Elaine didn't get the recognition, but she was solidly working there, you know, day in, day out, all of the time, and running things from behind the scenes, obviously. Mavis Shepherd, that was the hardware, haberdashery, whatever, with Colin Connor, and then Mrs. Mahassey, and then the garages as you went up the street. Mrs. Nell Vorwerg at the post office, as it was the switchboard. In those times too, as far as organising the CWA, it was quite a network of women. And there was a lot of self-help, I suppose, in getting in and organising thing. That I understood the land where the kindergarten initially was in Bergen Grove, that was owned by the CWA. And the CWA women, who were young mums at that stage, ended up making a decision to allocate that land for the kindergarten. And then the next generation of women that came through, there was a bit of a sense of you got in and you did it and you made things happen. In those days, women working probably outside the home wasn't as common. And also my mother's situation on the farm, You know, that would be that Dad was the farmer, but Mum was working in the shed. She was doing 6 hours a day, you know, milking. And many of Mum's closest friends, obviously, were wives of fishermen. So, and there was a bit of a sharing of produce because we would have crayfish frequently and we had cream. And so there was produce from the farm that went to friends and we swapped produce. Eileen Gorwin, she was one woman who had a cafe, but then she became worked in real estate. And she first started with Kath Rogan, started her experience there, then got her qualifications, and she was a real estate agent here. So having a woman in business like that on, yes, yeah, so there were women that were leaders, but not necessarily at a council or a local government level.
And as amazing as the women that shaped San Remo were, there were chinks in the armour.
I always remember going to your place, Violet, and it was when they bought fitted sheets in, you know, and you know how hard they were to fold them up. I went in Violet's drawer and she said, "This damn thing," and threw it at me. And do you remember doing that?
Yeah,
Every time I fold up one of them now, I
think of you.
She couldn't get it to do the way she wanted, so she was did it now.
All jokes aside, the women of San Remo have had a major part in building and shaping the town.
I don't know whether it still happens today, whether they're still there for each other like they were when we... Because it was a very small community in those days. And today there's many more people here.
I was going to say the friendship.
Yeah, and the whole community, really, it's a community thing. A lot of the kids that were original kids have all grown up and married and moved away. But it's always lovely to see them come back, and they all seem to come back. When you're born near the water, you need to be near the water.